What we do here is go back, 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 back.
What's going on, everybody? It's Jay Coffee Talk. Now, before we get into this thing, I'd like to ask that you guys slide right under this video. It just takes you a moment. Hit that like, that subscribe, and that notification bell. Help this channel grow, guys. The more the channel can grow, you know, the more I can put time into bringing you guys better content. Now, let's get into this update here. And, you know, the case against Eric Holder, who was charged with the murder of Nipsey Hussle. You know, everyone wants to see justice in this case. And, you know, there is some news regarding this. And that is that the DA decided, you know, to have the case revisited by a grand jury. Now, originally, he was charged, you know, with four crimes. And that was murder, two counts of attempted murder, and possession of a firearm by a felon. Well, you know, the grand jury added two new charges. And that's two counts of assault with a firearm. And that was for the two victims who did not die. Now, they decided to skip the preliminary hearing and go right to the grand jury. And, you know, I'm no legal analyst at all by any means, but I do know a little bit about the law. I mean, not really, you know, in something like high profile like this, like a murder case, but I have somewhat of an idea how the legal process works, as may others out there. If you guys, you know, have been incarcerated before, or, you know, fought a case, you know, things like that. Well, legal analysts are saying that the fact that they're decided to add additional charges like this and skip the grand the preliminary hearing and go straight to the grand jury, they're saying that's not necessarily a good sign. That is a tactic that you normally see when there is a problem with the case or like evidence or something like that. And I don't know, man. That just kind of has me worrying a little bit, a little nervous here, because as I said, there's, you know, no debate, no disputing. Everyone wants to see justice right now, you know. And in the hip hop world, you know, the police are always friends of the hip hop world. We'll just put it out there like that. But it would just suck that in this, you know, situation, you know, where the hip hop community and, you know, Nipsey Hussle's families, loved ones, fans all want to see, you know, Eric Holder prosecuted and, you know, convicted and, you know, hit with the bid or, you know, maybe more, whatever the, you know, whatever consequences may come in this situation. You know, the one time that people are rooting for you know, law enforcement and the justice system, that, you know, they don't come through and deliver. I mean, it would be a shame if there was some kind of something wrong with the evidence and you know, there was some kind of technicality. Now, I'm not saying I believe by, you know, any stretch that he will walk free. I'm just saying that, you know, who knows, you know, if there is something like that happens, I don't know, maybe it could cause for him to get a less of a bid or something like that, or they offer him a better deal. I don't know, but I'm just going by what these legal analysts said. I'm not saying, you know, this is exactly what happened, but there's something going on, right, as to why they would have added these new charges. So, you know, as I said, that's a tactic legal analysts are saying use when there's a problem with evidence or some kind of problem with the case. That way they can basically stack charges, you know, when it comes court time. Basically, you know, if there's a problem with this case, this one's gonna stick, basically. So I don't know exactly, you know, what the kind of problems they could have with the evidence. I mean, you know, maybe you hear stuff sometimes, evidence gets, you know, messed up while it's sitting, like transported to evidence room or during testing or something like that, and that would just be a shame. But I'm just purely speculating here and going by what the legal analysts are saying, guys. But as it stands, two new charges added, and, you know, he's indicted on those charges as well. So I don't know, guys. Get in the comments, let me know what you guys think about this. Any people out there, like, with a legal background or knowledge of the law, you know, as always, I definitely would want to hear what you guys got to say. As always, this channel is all about hearing your guys' feedback. So if someone does have some kind of expertise on this, please drop it in the comments. Once again, guys, thanks for watching the video. If you're new to the channel, I do sports, music, news, and hip-hop. So please hit that like, subscribe, and that notification bell so you can stay up on the channel. Look forward to hearing from you guys in the comments. And rest in peace, Nipsey Hussle. Till next time, it's Jay Coffee Talk. I'm out of here. Peace.